this interview because today there's a very important event at Bilob Asheville Liberation Station in downtown, and the topic is Eyewitness Venezuela. Let's talk about what is happening in this contest with Venezuela. You've been in Venezuela before, right?
Yes, I was in Venezuela from February 12 to March 12 this year, exactly 1 month, and I was there for some key events that took place regarding the U.S. government trying to find more pretext to overthrow the democratically elected president, Nicolas Maduro. And what I saw was the complete opposite of what the corporate media of the U.S. is saying. People are not starving. People are not suffering from this great repression of the government. But the U.S. is strangling the economy and trying to block food, medicine. And they've actually said, U.S. officials have said, we're going to overthrow the government and we're going to apply harder sanctions. We're going to basically encircle the country so that they force the overthrow of Maduro. It's a terrible, dangerous situation.
And what kind of information you will be sharing today? You got more images, videos to share, right?
In 1 month, I met many, many people in different sectors of society. So I will be showing basically four very short 3 to 8 minute videos of the food distribution program. The government is providing food to 6 million families on a regular basis, to show the housing, that more than 2.6 million homes have been built in Venezuela, and the people pay for them at a very nominal, symbolic price. In other words, they can complete the payment of a new home in less than a year. And here we have to do 30 years if you're even fortunate enough.
You're lucky to find one.
Yeah. And also, I visited 4 prisons in Venezuela, and I will be showing some of that. They have undergone a major radical reform of the prison system. They call it humanizing it, and I was deeply impressed.
Are you going to be talking also about what is happening in the Venezuela embassy?
Yes, it's something that most people in the U.S. are not aware of because the media is not covering it. But Washington, D.C. was the site of 35 days of peace activists protecting the Venezuelan embassy from a U.S. takeover. It's unprecedented. Never in modern history has an embassy been taken over by a foreign power. The Vienna Convention regarding diplomacy, embassies, and international law prohibits any country from violating the sanctity of another country's embassy. But the U.S. police, U.S. federal police, the Secret Service, invaded the embassy last week to take out 4 peace U.S. activists who were protecting the embassy and arrested them. To give it to the imposter pretender, Juan Guaido, and his staff.
Mm-hmm. So let's explain to our audience about the whole process, because the ambassador right now, it's an ambassador that is representing Guaido. It's Carlos Bicchio, right? So how Carlos Bicchio became an ambassador here?
Well, first, we've witnessed in Venezuela 20 years, almost exactly 20 years, of a new revolutionary process. It's the building of socialism in Venezuela, first with President Hugo Chavez. Unfortunately, he died in 2013, 6 years ago, and Nicolas Maduro was elected president as a result. Nicolas Maduro was reelected last year in May, but the process of the Bolivarian Revolution is using the oil wealth of the country, which is enormous, the largest reserves of oil in the world, to provide health care, housing, and 45 new universities that were built in 20 years. The U.S. wants none of this. The U.S. is very worried because previously the U.S., British, French, and Dutch corporations of oil controlled and made enormous profits. So with the re-election of Maduro last year, the U.S. decided that they were going to overthrow him once and for all. So in January of this year, right after Maduro was re-inaugurated, the U.S. brought a pretender, Juan Guaido, and on January 23rd, the day after Mike Pence told him it's your day, Juan Guaido, an unknown in the country, declared himself president. Unelected, he never even ran for president, and the U.S. has used that fiction to steal the oil, the gold, and other wealth of Venezuela in the international banks, the U.S. property that belongs to Venezuela of the oil, Citgo gas stations. It's all been taken over by the U.S. And what is at hand is a struggle over whether the government of Venezuela, representing the people, can continue to provide with its wealth, or whether the U.S. will succeed in overthrowing the government and returning that oil wealth back to the oil companies. Mm-hmm. That's really what's at hand.
So, and then the police was showing in the embassy and a letter, so asking them to remove the people inside. So that is was that letter lawfully written, or was fake?
Any communication or order or request by Juan Guaido, again, he is not a legitimate president, or his staff. He has named the ambassador in Washington from Venezuela to the U.S., Carlos Vecchio, V-E-C-C-H-I-O. He named him the ambassador. So any letter or communique from Vecchio is false, and yet the U.S. is recognizing it. It's a U.S. show. It's a U.S. montage.
But unfortunately, it based a bad precedent for all the countries, right?
Well, I think, Julio, you are aware, more than people in the U.S., being from another country, being more familiar with international law. Mm-hmm. Here, people are raised to think that we don't have to respect international law. But the international, the Vienna Convention regarding embassies, consulates, and diplomacy says that no embassy of another country can be touched by a foreign power. This is the first time that has happened with the U.S. takeover of the Venezuelan embassy. And why it is that people stayed for 35 days. There were days they had no water because the water was cut off. There were days they had no food. And the right-wing Venezuelans surrounded the embassy on behalf of the U.S. to keep the food out. And finally, the U.S. came in, invaded the embassy, and arrested the people. But we had a great march the day after.
Of course, and we are. Our intention is invite you to go today, May 22nd, at 6:30 p.m. at below Asheville Liberation Station, which is located in 10 North Market Street, Asheville, 28801. So thank you very much, Gloria, and thank you to you for be watching JM Pro TV.
Thank you.